What makes the new Tesla electric motor so great? Hi, my name is Markus, and hello together here from Berlin, the new second home of Tesla. Today I will show you the two types of electrical motors that Tesla is using. We will take a look at the advantages and disadvantages. And of course, I will show you what makes the Tesla electric motor so great. So let's get started. Which two types of electric motors does Tesla use now and why? So Tesla is using an induction motor, also known as an asynchronous motor, and a synchronous motor for their electric cars. The new synchronous motor is a combination of a permanent magnet synchronous motor, short PMSM, and a synchronous reluctance motor. We will first take a quick look at the normal PMSM and the induction motor so that we can better understand why Tesla is using a new additional electric motor. A PMSM has permanent magnets in the rotor, which follow the rotating magnetic field of the stator. Because induction motors have copper bars in the rotor instead of permanent magnets, an additional current is required in the stator to generate a magnetic field in or from the rotor. This results in the lower efficiency of induction motors at the lower speed range than synchronous motors with permanent magnets. However, induction motors achieve a slightly better efficiency at high speeds compared to a conventional PMSM. This is because an additional current is needed for the PMSM to weaken the magnets in the higher speed range. But exactly at high speeds, a very good efficiency is very important, because here the power or the energy consumption is very high. The induction motor also has safety advantages, a higher temperature resistance, and is very inexpensive to manufacture, because the motor does not contain permanent magnets. If you want to understand exactly how an induction motor works, you can find a detailed video in the description. Why does Tesla now use an electric motor with expensive permanent magnets? Nevertheless, Tesla combines a conventional PMSM with a synchronous reluctance motor. This has the advantage that the current needed to weaken the magnets can be reduced or used to generate an additional reluctance torque. Therefore, the new motor can achieve even higher efficiencies at high speeds than an induction motor. The design of the magnets is called V-shape, and over the angle of the magnets and the position, you can adjust the influence of the reluctance torque. Another advantage compared to the induction motor is that you do not need to cool the shaft with liquid, because the new electric motor has lower losses in the rotor. This makes the drive system more robust and cost-effective. Instead of 4 magnet poles, the new Tesla electric motor has 6 magnetic poles. This increased the torque of the motor, but it also increased the losses in the sheet metal, in the windings and in the permanent magnets, especially at high speeds. This is also a reason why the permanent magnets are divided into segments, to reduce their losses. But what makes Tesla's new electrical motor so great now? Well, it is not the principle of the electric motor type, because other manufacturers like Toyota have been using this type of electric motor for a long time. The answers are the small details, such as the cooling, the position sensor, and the permanent magnets. Tesla's development engineers have done a really good job with these details. If you have more specific questions about the details, just write them in the comments. I will answer your questions and help you out. If you enjoyed the video, share it, like it, and please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching, and I wish you all an excellent efficiency.